Casey Cortez, the star setter for Bacolod Taytong High School, has been at the forefront of their supremacy in Pool B. On the flip side, you have Margaret Altea, the heart and soul for this amazing UST High School squad. Can the Thunderbolts stay unbeaten, or will the UST Golden Tigresses show that they could take down one of the tournament's favorites? As we take a look at our schedule for the day, nung first game po natin, NU Nazareth School took down FEU Diliman in straight sets. Our last two matches, we have California Academy taking on Adamson University. And our very last game, Naga College Foundation, kalaban naman ang De La Salle Lipa. Which brings us to our second game of our quarterfinal quadruple header. Bacolod Taytong High School will take on UST Junior Tigresses. Ken Pangalinan and Holly Reyes pa rin makakasama nyo live on CNN Philippines Top Sports Plus Network and on the Shaky Super League social media pages as we see our updated playoff bracket here, Holly.
Yes, NU Nazareth School won over FEU in straight sets earlier today. The next match is Bacolod Taytong against UST. So, inaabangan natin, no? Kung sino yung mananalo dito to give a seat for the next slot for the semifinals.
And mananalo nga sa labanang ito will face the winner of Naga College Foundation against De La Salle Lipa. Punta na natin itong Bacolod Taytong High School. They were part of arguably the toughest group in the preliminary round in Pool P, but they were able to finish unscathed going into the quarterfinal round.
Yes, Bacolod Taytong very dominant also on their round. On their pool. They have the players, key players that contribute in a consistent basis. Ramos being the captain, but also Cortez, as you said on our opening segment, na siya yung medyo nililook forward to na pinapanood dito. And also De Leon and also Chuatico, middle blockers are very dominant inside their matches so far.
So they finished first in Pool B by defeating Adamson, LPU Cavite, and Kings Montessori School. Samantala naman, tungo na tayo dito sa UST Junior Tigresses. Tough way to start in their pool. They lost to Naga College Foundation, but they finished strong and meron silang momentum coming into this round.
Yes, back-to-back wins against in their game yesterday with LaSalle Zobel. So this confidence may be also a carryover on this match. Bacolod Taytong and UST much awaited din yung kanilang matchup because, you know, they have their strong points also with UST. So let's see dominance over yesterday, as you see on your screen. Very convincing win yesterday.
Yeah, nagtapos sila 2-1 record in Pool D. So can UST secure the biggest win of the tournament, or will Bacolod Taytong reign supreme once again? We'll find out as we turn you over to Mix Torres.
Alexia Bonpo and Francesca Hermosa, number 12, Donna May De Leon. And their first libero is number 3, Aliyah Marie Sulan. Head coach for the Thunderbolts is Ian Macariola. And now the starting lineup for the University of Santo Tomas Junior Tigresses. Number 8, team captain Margaret Altea. Number 3, Jayla Drao. Number 10, Stephanie Arasan. Number 12, Lian Pinuliar. Number 15, Ashley Magnayi. Number 18, Abigail Sinson. And their starting libero is number 4, Francesca Rodriguez. Head coach for the Junior Tigresses is Ler Magueron.
Here we go, Bacolod Taytong High School taking on the UST Junior Tigresses as we take a look at the starting six for both squads. Of course, for Taytong, we have the star setter, Casey Cortez, Chuatico, Jotea Ramos, Alex Montoro, Hermosura, Donna May De Leon, and their starting libero is Isulan. Samantala naman for UST, Jayla Adrao, Marga Altea, Stephanie Arasan, Lian Pinuliar, Ashley Magnay is their starting setter, Abigail Sinson, and Rodriguez naman kailang starting libero. So, and what promises to be a fun and intriguing matchup between Bacolod Taytong High School and UST. Set number one underway, brought to you by Shakey Super Delivery. Order favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. And not a way to start the set if your USD service error kontra Magnay.
Yeah, giving Bacolod itong first point. Easy point. So, hopefully, they can recover from that first point.
And here she is, Casey Cortez. Good serve. Magnay. Cortez inabol. Ramos. Back set to Marge Altea. Punta sa kabila to Sinson. Cortez na nag-first ball. Ramos goes to Montoro. And challenging the blockers there.
First point. Second point for Bacolod Titans, but that rally was pretty intense, you know, balikan ng bola. So you see also the high intensity of both teams coming into this match. Kasi alam nga nila, very crucial ito.
So interesting, wala dito so far si Adrao. And si the player of the game last time, that was Lipat. But Simpson, sabi niya, she will perform really well.
Yes, maybe Coach Lerma, you know, trying to feel muna of the game. Kung hindi naman natin kayang ipasok because of more crucial matches, so medyo mind games na ngayon this coming quarterfinals.
Here she is, Marga Altea, second best middle blocker. And now, firing an ace.
Good serve by Altea. The liberos of Bacolod Titong was left there in the middle.
And that serve the game brought to you by Shakey Super Delivery. Order favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. Tying things up, 2-2. Cortez underhand set. Papunta ay Montoro. Through the block ulit.
Montoro giving that cross-court hit.
So the MVP of the match in their last game, kahapon lang, against King's Montessori School, Alex Montoro from Silay City, Negros Occidental.
Good pass.
Nice.
Good set.
Quick set para dito ay Penulyar. Take a look at that once again.
Penulyar making her presence felt early on this match.
And Holly, how important is it to for UST to come out strong against a formidable squad like Bacolod Titong High School?
Yes, I think the energy always has to be there, you know, just to give them confidence. And you see already, medyo mahina, medyo yung kanilang galaw, no? You see also everybody is, you know, moving well, aggressiveness. So yun yung gusto natin makita on the first set pa lang. Kasi alam nga nila na itong match ito is gonna be a crucial one for them.
I love the vibe and the start from USD. They lead now 4-3. As a violation whistled against Casey Cortez. Double contact daw.
That was a little bit off na pass from the libero. Ginawa niya lang ng paraan but nahuli ng referee natin. Good call by the referee.
For Bacolod Titong, although arguably nga toughest yung kanilang group as an error against USD. Although toughest nga among the pools yung grupo nila, you have there yung King's Montessori School and Adamson. He still came out undefeated, so hindi mo rin masabi na nasubukan sila during that stretch. So probably this is their first sign of adversity.
Yes.
You could say.
Yes, makikita mo ng aggressiveness din on both teams.
As Ramos overcooks that one. So another error kontra dito sa Titong.
As you said, the energy already. You feel it pa lang on the first few points. So mahirap ulit. Mahirap madictate yung pace ngayon ng match. Kasi actually evenly matched out. Middles has been consistent. Open spikers has been consistent also throughout the league. So, kumbaga, it's a good indication that we're up for a good match ngayong araw na to.
But countering with a service error of her own, ito si Simpson. So shaky start for both teams. At you got here, ito si Jotea Ramos. Dito sa Taitong, goes for the jump serve. Arasan. Picked up there by Hermosura. De Leon. And a net touch violation again against the girls in white.
Medyo may gigil si De Leon doon. But I can understand because it was only a single block.
So 7-5. Again, winner here will face the winner of the match later on at 4 p.m. between Naga College Foundation and De La Salipa. Good set para dito kay De Leon.
That was just a simple tip by De Leon, not as powerful as the one she gave earlier. But lumusot sa block. So it means the blockers of USA is there but not well established.
So 7-6. Hermosura. Jump serve. Picked up by Sinson. Altea. And mistiming her approach. So pinag-usapan natin actually off-air, Holly, na Marge Altea is one of the most reputable players coming in to this tournament. And so far, although decent na may performance siya, ang we haven't seen her really show her dominant self for UST. As Casey Cortez with the 1-2. And Ramos, smart play right there.
Good play by Bacolod Taitong, giving them the first technical timeout.
And Taitong, 3 straight points. First technical timeout tayo, lamang sila by a point, 8-7. But Holly, you gotta love what you're seeing so far from both teams.
Yes, makikita mo yung ano no, pareho sila lang fighting. They try to outsmart each other, but kumbaga nagpapakaramdaman pa sila. But going back to Altea, once you said, yes, I agree, she hasn't given her parang kumbaga the what she can do. Kasi coming into this, medyo, yun nga, medyo shaky pa. But hopefully, we will see more of her and more of her, you know, strengths and dominance into the court. Into this match, as you said, maybe Altea can also show this one of the crucial matches for them. So, baka ito na yung chance for her to, kumbaga, dominate on this.
But you know, the good news, but before that, tignan natin ang ating Shaky Super Fans of the Day brought to you by Shaky Super Delivery. Order favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. But you know, good news naman, despite the fact na ganun nga, you got girls like Jaila Adrao and Jacqueline Lipat really stepping up para dito sa UST.
Yes, UST has already been a dominant, you know, in the high school division and even the grade school and college. So you will see also the players that they produce as really quality. It's all around players that can contribute, like Altea, that one, giving them that point, you know, that cross-court hit. Because of her reach, mahirap basahin kung saan babaksak o saan pupuntos yung kanyang bola.
And it seems like an adjustment process then for Marge. Kasi nga, nung nakaraang UAP season 85, she was playing the middle blocker position as ito, Adrao with the service ace. But right now, nasa outside hitter position siya eh.
Yes, maybe that's also maybe one of the factors that you haven't seen too much of her because nasa gitna nga siya before or middle blocker position and now is being out to the open. So, meron pang konting ano, adjustment period.
As a block, but picked up there. So, ito, reset tayo. Magnaye, Altea with the left, but it sails out.
Sayang, she was trying maybe swipe it off the hands of the blockers. Pero napasobreng swipe ng kamay niya.
So, good response for Taitong. Tabla tayo, 9-all. Good set once again!
That is a good receive and a good set. You see those plays, no? Combination plays of quick patong. Ibig sabihin, inactivate agad ng setters ang kanilang mga gitna just to kumbaga, give them a thinking game in the middle.
Their setter, Ashley Magnay, rising up to the challenge. Alam niya, kalaban niya, isang magaling din na setter sa kabila na si Casey Cortez. But meanwhile, error again against Bacolod Taytong.
I think the set was pretty low, na itilit pa. So kaya hindi nag-over yung palo.
So USD with the momentum, they are up by 2. Cortez for the 1-2 using her left hand. Magdaye goes to Altea. Cortez punta sa kanya, open hitter. But that time, net touch violation against USD.
USD too eager on the net. That's why they're committing errors little by little.
And both teams really committing those errors. 5 so far for Bacolod Taytong. 4 naman for UST. Casey Cortez, we all know where she's going. And overcooks that serve. So tabla na tayo sa errors. 5 apiece for both squads.
So you also see based on their errors, so maybe nerves also of the gravity of this match. Medyo siguro nagkakapaan pa talaga sila.
Altea with the serve. Cortez goes to her quicker. Chuatico. Magnaye. Simpson. And miscommunication on the part of Bacolod Taytong.
Block was there, but you know, coverage wasn't. Sayang yung kanilang block on that sequence.
Abigail Sinson so far with 3 points. And 3 points din ang kalamangan ng USD, 13-10. Cortez goes to Chuatico. Finally, she's on the board.
Good decoy there by Chuatico. She was giving that powerful spike pero tinip over niya lang. So she saw that the libero or the coverage for it was pretty late from UST.
Magnay, hinabol yung bola. Sinson, that's a tough angle and she won't get the ball across.
Good serve by Montoro. Nahihirapan si UST magpasa ng kanilang first ball.
And Montoro is really key nung laban nila kahapon against Kings Montessori School. Kasi tumidikit na sila yung Kings Montessori. And those timely serves galing sa kanya. But meanwhile, look at that! Arasan! Wendy power spike!
That was picture perfect. Having one blocker, doing that cross-court angle.
At nakikita ko yung kanyang mom watching in attendance, Jennifer Arasan, of course, a former San Sebastian Ladies tag, as Penulyar with a service ace.
Good serve by Penulyar. Making the libero, Bacolod Taytong guess.
Ganda na simula ng USD. Just a perfect start.
You want that energy, no? Sana mag-sustain. Yun yung ating kailangan, kumbaga, key.
As Jotea Ramos gets it over.
Smart move by Ramos. Swiping off the hands of the blockers of UST.
Bacolod Taytong naman, the queens of Western Visayas, and has also made waves here in the national scene. Nakita man natin yung mga panalo nila against Adamson, against KMS. Magnaye goes to Arasan once again. Good pick up there by Hermosura. Ramos was blocked. She will try once again. And this time she goes through the blockers to score that point para dito sa Bacolod Taytong.
Mahabol si Bacolod Taytong dito. Good coverage by Bacolod and that spike by Ramos.
So it's 15-14. We have a good one so far. Second match pa lang po ito. We still have 2 more quarterfinals matches. And yun, naghihintay na in that other part of this bracket. Magnaye. She goes to Simpson. A draw. Arasan off speed. Ramos na nag-set. They go to Hermosura and drilling it.
Another down the line spike by Hermosura. Good cover by Cortez and nice up by Ramos. Perfect pass. Go to Hermosura and make that down the line shot.
Perfect pass, perfect swing. And they tie things up 15-all. Magnaye, gusto adraw, masyadong mababa yung set. And it leads us to our second technical timeout lamang dito. Ngayon ang Bacolod Titong 16-15. Us here as we invite our volleyball fans. May pagkaaton kayo manaal ng 500 pesos worth of Shakey's gift certificates in Plus Network's Guess Who contest. All you have to do is guess the name of the volleyball player through the pictures that we will be showing and the clues that we will share within the game. Make sure that you tune in and watch all the matches today to get all the pictures and clues. Visit Plus Network's Facebook page to learn more. So makita niyo yung unang picture, pusa. Nagkaka-idea na ba kayo? Sino? Pinapahulaan namin. As Magnaye goes to Arasan once again. Great recovery by Ramos. A draw. Blocked. And hindi na naitawid yung bola doon.
It's a good try by UST, never giving up on the ball. But eventually, fell on UST. With the substitution now.
So, pinasok na muna dito si Bahamonde. Pinaltan muna si Adrao. So, 5 straight points for Bacolod Titong after trailing by 3 earlier. So, it's 17-15. Arasan, cross-court. Good pick-up by Hermosura. Ramos. And net touch violation. So the errors piling up kontra dito sa UST.
You see also the intensity. May konting gigil na with UST. They could have converted that point already.
Let's listen in to a huddle ni Coach Ler Magiron.
Doon, sa pagyaya now. Eh, okay now. Ante, pero kailangan natin diyan mo.
Blackero, Spiker, gamitin nyo na yung kamay nila. Palabas! Okay, wipe out nyo. Ngayon, kailangan maging matalino tayo kung anong offense ang gagawin ninyo. Hindi tayo makapuntos eh.
Come on!
Coach Lerma just breaking the momentum now for Bacolod Titong and giving instructions to the girls saying that use the blocker's hands or use Bacolod Titong's hands on the block para makapuntos kayo on your spike. And they're also, coach is also mentioning about, you know, using their head and making more variation of their shots.
And good timeout, breaking the momentum itong Bacolod Titong. Service error kontra sa kanila. And now at the service line, Simpson. Top scoring for UST alongside Pinulyar. 3 points each. Cortez, combination play. And Ramos scoring once again.
You can see how confident Cortez is setting the ball and giving it to Ramos. Kahit medyo missed receive na, ibigay niya pa din with that jump set at the back.
19-16. They go to Arasan through the block.
Arasan breaking through that block. She wasn't intimidated by De Leon there. De Leon was a little bit late on positioning her hands.
Her mom watching in attendance. Ito si Stephanie Arasan. Good serve. And that is out. So USD inching closer. Parang ipaliwanag nga, Miss Holly, gano'ng agaling itong mom nito ni Stephanie Arasan?
I think noong time niya talaga namang formidable, no? Sa San Beda. So, may pagmamanahan.
But this time around, it was Marge Altea putting it home. Narigaluhan doon. Ayan naman, itong USD nakatabla na dito. 19 all. Pakinggan naman natin si Coach Ian Macariola.
Pass lang. Balukan. Yung nakakatake. Isang aton ko pinta. Kung may tama yung receive. Hindi yan. You know what? Isa na yung receive. Ah. Nah, relax lang. Okay. Sino first line? Subong opener. And follow na doon. Doon. Tasig kasod sa bula. Doon. Natawa na yung receive. Tasig ka inagaw sa bula.
Ay,
yung patikit ang bula. Ay, yung
patikit ang taas.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3. Lights. Sino yung lights?
Hindi ako marunong mag-ilonggo, pero yung naiintindihan ko konti doon sa sinabi ni coaches, they have to get a first pass muna para maka-opensa sila ng maganda. So, the girls was just reminding, coach was just reminding the girls to have that first pass for them to be able to get the points.
So, 19 all. Cortez sets up Hermosura. Cortez na tumawid ng bola. And De Leon, naregaluhan din and capitalizing.
I like how aggressive De Leon in the middle is, no? Hindi niya pinibitawan yung bola. He just keeps on moving and moving into the ball.
So it's 2019. Bacolod recovering just in time, but matagal pa ito. Set number one. Altea finally making her presence felt.
That down the line hit by Altea. Walang power pero tamang placed lang.
Finding a spot in the corner. Marge Altea. 20 all. Cortez, back set. De Leon dumping it in.
De Leon seeing the hole at the back of the blockers. Altea was left behind there.
And substitutions coming in. Papaltan muna si Donna May De Leon. And circus specialist Ramos.
Is she the younger sister? I think they're siblings, but you don't know kung sino yung mas matanda.
So this one is Jonil Ramos. Magnaye. Gusto Altea. Ramos was there. Chuatico na nag-set para dito ay Montoro. And she was blocked there by Penulyar.
Good defense on the USD side. Not giving up on that ball.
So ayaw magpaawat ng magkabilang kupunan. Tabla ulit tayo. 21 all. And good serve. Magnaye delivering for USD.
That is what the coach of Bacolod Titan has been reminding the girls, is to get that first pass muna for them to be able to get the points.
But that time around, that ball sails out.
They have a tight ball game. 22 all.
Dikdikan tayo ngayon. 22 all. Casey Cortez. Can she bring home itong Bacolod Titan in this set? Magnaye goes to Altea. And that is out.
That's a crucial mistake by Altea.
11th error na kontra dito sa UST. Kaya painggan muna natin ang kailang huddle dito.
Anong kulang? Ha? Anong kulang? Kailangan mo identify. Anong kulang? Maganda yung plano. Ito lang mali. Oh, pinlock ball natin. Oh, bawi tayo. Wala na tayong magagawa doon. Pasa tayo ng isa, ha? Okay? Nasa likod ka pa? Oh, tatlo yung spiker mo sa harapan. Ah, let's go, let's go. Maging bibi tayoan. Bibi the sword.
Coach Delma just reminding their girls their options on spike. Giving more instructions on Altea and focusing on her because sayang yung kanyang last point na binigay. It's just a little simple reminder on how to contact the ball. You know, hopefully, Altea can recover from that.
And I love how Coach Lerma didn't left eto si Marge Altea off the hook. Immediately, para ma-orek agad. Tingnan natin how will she do in that joust, pero nabitin pa rin doon. So it's now set point for Bacolod Taytong. Ayan naman, papaltan muna ito si Marga Altea, ito ni Jacqueline Lipat, who was the MVP of the match kahapon din in their game.
Let's see what Lipat can do. Maybe one good pass for UST.
Lipat was the MVP of the match nung laban nila against De La Salle Zobel. But here, Casey Cortez. Lipat. Cortez goes to Ramos and she drills it home.
Good spike by Ramos and first good ball from Taito.
And they finish off the set. A tough one at that, but nonetheless, Bacolod Taytong on top, 25-22 against the UST Junior Tigresses. So great job by them. Tignan natin if UST could bounce back in the second set. Tandaan natin, this is a knockout quarterfinals match. Set number 2 in just a bit when we return only here on the Shakey's Girls Volleyball Invitational League. With us here as Bacolod Taytong taking this first set against UST 25-22 as we invite our volleyball fans. Dahil may pagkaatan kayo, manalo ng 500 pesos worth of Shakey's gift certificates and Plus Network's Guess Who contest. All you have to do is guess the name of the volleyball player through the pictures that we will be showing and the clues that we will share within the game. Make sure that you tune in and watch all the matches today to get all the pictures and clues, visit Plus Network's Facebook page to know more. So, good start to this game. UST versus Bacolod Taytong. UST actually took the lead briefly, 15-12 in the middle part of this first set. But six straight points by Bacolod Taytong gave them the driver's seat. Actually, tumabla pa tayo, Holly, 22-all. But ang ganda ng finish nitong Bacolod Taytong to snatch this set away from UST.
Yes, Taytong adjusted already on their first ball. That's why dumikit na at naglamangan na nila si UST. UST gave that crucial error by Altea, which changed a little bit the pace of the game already.
Let's take a look at some of the numbers here.
You will see attacks lamang si Taytong, 10 si UST, but errors again. UST giving more errors to Bacolod Taytong.
Set number 2 underway and it's brought to you by Shakey's Super Delivery. Order your favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. Montoro through the block once again.
Still being consistent on that. Even though the set was pretty a little bit low, push through niya yung palo dun sa block ng UST.
And interesting na we're starting off set number 2, wala sa loob si Marga Altea.
Yeah, maybe Coach Nerma is trying, you know, make things up just to see what combination works for UST.
Actually, I'm seeing Coach Kung Fu Reyes talking to Marga Altea, getting into her ear.
Maybe just giving her pointers and, you know, confidence building. Kasi medyo crucial nga yung kanyang errors kanina.
Actually, dalawang sunod yun. Just as she was getting into her rhythm. So, tingnan natin if she could bounce back, especially in that this game is still up for grabs. As Ramos once again, no answer coming from UST on that attack.
Ramos spiking that quick attack down the line. Nakita niya late yung blocker, so that's why she pounded that on a down the line hit.
So 2-1. Coach Kung Fu, of course. Talagang matututo si Marga Altea dyan, having handled the likes of Alisa Valdez, di ba? At Dindin Santiago. But that time around, Bacolod Taytong finding their groove. And they have a strong start to the second set, Holly.
Another clever hit or clever pass at the back by Ramos. Just pushing the ball at the back where the players were scrambling to get it.
3-1. And that is out galing dito kay Montoro. So UST, they've shown that they could keep up at least in the first set. And here she is, Stephanie Arasan.
She's been very, very consistent. You know, front line and back line. And
ayan,
service.
Pa, right on cue.
It wasn't a powerful hit, no? It's just a well-placed shot lang.
One of the leading scorers, 4 points, together with Pinulyar and Altea. Tabla tayo, 3-all. Like we said earlier, winner will face the winner naman ng matchup later between Naga College Foundation and La Salle pa. Pinulyar na nag-set, para ay lipat. Chuatico with a quick hit.
That was a nice hit by Chuatico. Good pass, good set, good spike.
Great job galing dito kay Gian Chuatico.
You see how the form of the middle blockers of Taytong, medyo threat talaga sila in the middle.
Lipat. And she clips the line. Good job galing dito kay Jacqueline Lipat.
Lipat making her presence felt and her variation of shots to keep the Bacolod Taytong guessing.
Jacqueline Lipat also played for De La Salle pa before and was a wall spiking champion sa Southern Luzon Colleges and Universities Athletic Association Virtual Volleyball Skills Competition as we see a service ace coming here from Pinulyar.
End of the line service for Pinulyar. Yung ganun, hindi mo alam kung lucky siya, lucky serve, or really well-placed.
Actually, at least in terms of service, maganda ang laro ng USD. They have 6 service aces already. As De Leon, Magnaye, si Enzeto lipat, once again delivering para dito sa USD.
You see how fast-paced the game is, no? The aggressiveness on both teams. So makikita mo, it's a good matchup talaga.
So USD lamang ulit dito, 6-4. Pinulyar, the service line. Another good serve. And that ultimately gives the point para dito sa Junior Tigresses. Long ball contact violation against Bacolod Taytong. And let's listen in sa timeout nitong Thunderbolts. They are down by 3 points.
Ang problema siya ba? Ang receive naman ta. Eh, paano ito yung Silbaron ng atong problema, guys? Front and back. What? Jot! Eport na ba, Jot? Paliwag, Jot! Jot, eport na, Jot! Paliwag, Jot! Sa block, Jot! Ikaw, man, Lodge. What? Receive na, eh. Go! Good! Pasa na yung front, eh. Sa block na. Timing! 1, 2, 3.
I think coach is just reminding the girls that, again, the passing of the first ball is very important for them to have those powerful hits or sa bola, kumbaga makapuntos sila. So yun din yung nawala ngayon eh. Medyo kaya din lumalayo yung score ni UST is because they don't have a first ball.
Lian Pinulyar has been serving well. And ball is still in play. Ramos. And off the block it goes.
Ramos has been aggressive on that spike. You see, the set isn't too high. Dinadaan sa mabilis. Kaya na-late doon si Lipat on that block.
Jotea Ramos was an MVP in that invitational tournament they had in Antique. But that time, service error, which leads us to our first technical timeout with UST on top, 8-5. So, Holly, different start para dito sa USD. Actually, lumamang pa nga Bacolod Taytong, I think 3-1 in this set. Pero ang ganda ng bawi nitong mga naka-itim.
Actually, they've been serving hard. Yun ang isang factor now, no? Maganda yung service ng USD now. Maybe they're getting the feel of the ball and, you know, of the game. So, the service has been deep and hard. So, nahihirapan basahin at saka ipasa ng Bacolod Taytong yung mga services nila. Kaya medyo nadidisrupt yung kanilang offense ngayon.
Let's see if UST could sustain this run that they're having. But first, we have our fun family pizza of the game brought to you by Shakey's Super Delivery. Order favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. Really enjoying this match, and why not? Maganda ang palitan ng puntos. If you just tuned in, UST led 15-12 in set number 1. At dikdikan nga towards the latter part of the set, 22-all tayo nun. But Bacolod Taytong with a strong finish to get the first set. As a service error galing dito sa UST gives the point back to Bacolod Taytong. First error kontra dito sa USD in the set.
Let's see paano sila babawi ngayon. One good pass by USD.
Hermosura gets it. Service ace galing sa kanya.
Another well-placed service by Bacolod Taytong. Kinabig niya.
Good job galing dito kay Hermosura. Magnaye goes to lipat through the block, it goes.
She's focusing more on the smaller blocker, lipat, targeting the hands of Cortez on that last spike.
Very cerebral player. Pasilipat. Here she is with a serve. Montoro. Cross court. That is out.
Good intention by Montoro pero nakalakas lang ng konti.
So it's Pacolo Taitong's turn to pile up the errors. They have four now in this set. Cortez. She goes to Montoro and finds a spot in the corner.
Good spike by Montoro again. Looking that late defense at the back by UST. You see, no? Hindi siya nag-hesitate. Eh. Alam niya kung saan niya dadalhin yung bola.
Donna May De Leon with a good serve and a service ace para sa kanya.
Good serve by De Leon. Ipat wasn't pretty sure or was even ready sa kanya pupunta yung bola.
You know, fun story about to si Donna May De Leon. Actually, she's a track and field athlete pero nag-transfer siya to volleyball during the pandemic as Arasan once again scoring para dito sa UST.
Nakakatawa yung mga crossover, no? Yung mga gano'n dating track player, tapos naging volleyball. Then we also have kumbaga badminton trainer, yung volleyball, yung mga gano'n. So it just sees, shows the kumbaga the growth of the sport.
Cortez kneeling down to set it up to Montoro and she gets it to go.
Powerful hit by Montoro. Getting bothered by the double block.
So just a 1-point lead for UST. Here she is. Casey Cortez has already committed to the Ateneo Blue Eagles program. Won a silver medal back in the 2019 Palarong Pambansa. Magnaye. Arasan once again. Really aggressive.
She's not that tall, but the aggressiveness and the power of her spikes. They see the confidence in her.
Ang tapang. May swag pang onte after that hit. So 12-10.
Good serve by Magnaye. Let's see what play.
Pagkakataon sa mga nakapaitim. Blocked there by Chuatico. Free ball naman para sa Taitong. They go to Ramos. Arasan once again. Pero net touch ang tinawag against Bacolod Taitong. Nonetheless, puntos pa rin para sa UST.
Chuatico was there but medyo may konting gigil. That's why she had her hands on the net.
It's 13-10, much like first set. Numumang nga doon UST, 15-12. Ang tanong, can they finish the job? Chuatico blocked! Cortez, tough angle. Ramos rather, di na niya nakuha yung bola doon.
Good read by Panoliar. Not letting off Chuatico on that last spike.
Biggest lead so far for UST at 4, 14-10.
Another good serve.
Cortez back set para ay Montoro.
Nabasa na yon ni UST.
Arasan! Wow! She's been doing a spectacular job attacking itong depensa ng Bacolod Taitong.
You see, may konting spunk dun sa talon niya eh. So, you see the confidence in her now.
And now, let's listen in to a timeout by Coach Ian Macariola.
Advantage na sa inyo, kinakuha ka mo isang set. Pero wag ka pa luya, baka mo. Ang baka sa inyo, double effort. Buyaan nyo pa na. Ano? Guys, asta lang ko sambal. Imuha nyo sunod court yung instruction. Pamati, focus. Ang black tao, receive na din. Tinitag ko na rin, Jay! Jay! Napang maribong ka, Jay!
Best one straight, sir.
Coach of Bacolod Titong showing a little bit of frustration, you know. He was saying, I think, meron lamang tayo ng isang set, so dapat medyo mas double effort tayo ngayon para matapos na natin to at mapanalo natin tong game. So it's just reminding the girls again na kumbaga advantage tayo coming into the second set.
Four straight points na ang UST. Make that six. Service ace.
Magnay giving Bacolod Titong a hard time on that first pass. She's been serving pretty well.
And now it's a six-point lead for UST. 16-10 as we head now to our second technical timeout. With us here at the San Andres Sports Complex in Manila as we invite our volleyball fans because you have a chance to win 500 pesos worth of Shakey's gift certificates in Plus Network's Guess Who contest. All you have to do is guess the name of the volleyball player through the pictures that we will be showing and the clues that we will share within the game. Make sure that you tune in and watch all the matches today to get all the pictures and clues. Visit Plus Network's Facebook page to know more. And immediately, well, actually, outside, yung palo doon, yung tip-in doon, rather, ni Jotea Ramos. So, another point para dito si UST.
Actually, they're trying to have a check ball on that. Pero the referee says it was no check and it was an outside.
Biggest lead so far for UST, 17-10. That's already six straight points from the girls from España.
Renewed energy ang meron sa UST. So you see also, no, makikita mo sa mga mata nila talagang they want this second set.
And you gotta love yung gamble ni Coach Lerma na wala si Altea sa loob. As Montoro scoring once again.
Coach Lerma medyo focusing now on the, not on the height. It's more on, you know, the right combination of people.
Sa gumanda yung galaw ng girls here in the second set, tong UST. 17-11. Sinson. Walang tapik doon. Oh, actually. Okay, so the referee's just confused. So four touches. So point goes to Bacolod Titong.
I think UST thought there was a check ball.
Oo.
Pero sabi ng ating first referee, wala.
Let's see if Bacolod Titong could mount a comeback and they started with that service ace para dito kay Alex Montoro.
Good hard serve by Montoro to the UST libero. Giving him the second point after the technical timeout.
Bacolod Titong High School hasn't dropped a set in this tournament. Lahat ng panalo nila sa kailang pool was straight sets lahat. And mounting errors para dito sa UST. Kaya naman Coach Lerma Giron pressing the timeout button. Let's listen in.
Hinga lang. Deep breath lang. Sige. Kunin niyo ulit yung sarili niyo. Ha? Okay, ganito gagawin natin. Hard ball. No? Hindi kailangan perfect pass. Kailangan may taas lang natin na may set ni A. Ready yung wing natin. Ngayon, kung ma-receive na maayos, humingi ang middle. Huwag ka manggigil. Ha? Kailangan ng composure. Kailangan kontrolado natin yung sarili natin. Huwag tayo maging aligaga. Lamang tayo, tatlo. Pero huwag natin hayaan ipamigay yan.
Let's go!
Oh, let's go! Laban natin!
Coach Lerma just reminding the girls that they're on top of things on this set. Give them, Titong has giving them hard serves. That's why medyo lumalapit yung score. But sabi ni coach, hindi natin kailangan ng magandang pasa. Kumbaga lamang patayo. Patayin natin ang isa. Sagain natin, kumbaga. yung puntos na ito.
Three straight points galing dito sa Bacolod Taytong. This is a knockout quarterfinals match. And another error galing dito sa UST. Actually, tatlong sunod na yan, Holly.
Yes, the pass was there, the set, but the miscommunication on the set for the middle blocker, Penuliar, led and, to that mistake.
And you don't want to give a slight opening to a team like Bacolod Taytong. Dalawa na lang, hinahabol nila. Arasan, another error kontra dito sa UST.
That's already four consecutive errors on UST. They just don't regroup and kumbaga recover.
Coach Jennifer, tinitignan ko sa bleachers as a coach. Sa sakit ng ulo ng ganyan. Puro error. Nandyan ka na eh.
Another good pass. Let's see.
Arasan.
Bumawi yung Arasan.
Si Ramos na nag-underhand set. Paka Hermosura. Sinson through the block. Cortez back set. Ramos. Good block there by Penuliar.
Good block and good read by UST. They were ready for that fast set for Ramos.
So just momentarily stopping itong run nitong Bacolod Taytong.
That's a good block.
18-16.
Good serve again.
Oh. Ramos was denied. Pero buhay pa ang bola. Penuliar. Andun si Cortez. Actually, that was Hermosura. And Jotea Ramos finishing the job.
Cortez is giving really those fast sets, no? Para lang hindi maka-establish ng block yung UST. You see how fast that was. Wala na. Left-footed na sila UST and Penuliar with Ramos on that side.
And now the younger Ramos will check in. Papaltan niya dito si Chotico. So maniniguro si Coach Ian sa service dito. How tough is it, Holly, na papasok ka para sumerve at a crucial juncture of a set?
Actually, it is very crucial, no? Nasa player din yan eh. Kung talagang tried and tested na parang kaya ko to. Pero meron ding iba na parang kaya ko ba?
Tricky situation.
Tricky, totoo.
Magnay ngayon, sinet up si Lipat. Medyo tahimik siya here in the latter stages ng set. Hermosura, good rally. Good pick up by Arasan. And a net touch against Bacolod Taytong, giving the point to UST. Coach Ian does not believe so.
Pero umamin si De Leon on that last point. May konting gigil na sila. Nagmamadali na sila masyado eh. So I think Taytong has to, you know, calm themselves down.
And pinasok na si Marga Altea, but this time she's playing the middle blocker position.
Another good serve.
And good tap in galing dito kay Donna May De Leon.
Miscommunication there on UST. Nakuha na yung first ball but nobody recovered from that second ball.
So dikita na naman tayo. 19-18.
Parang ganito din kanina, no?
Oo, kanina ganun.
Isa lang din yung pinupuntos nila eh.
22-all kanina yung first set before Taytong had a great finish to that set. Look at the power there from De Leon, but good net defense galing dito sa UST. Magnai ngayon. Combination play, that will work. Sinson!
Si Osa Magnai gambling on that middle. Confidence na kaya niya ibigay on that middle.
Ganda ng setup. De Leon was hesitant on that block. Wala siya nagawa doon. And it's now 2018. UST looking to tie things up at one set apiece.
Good serve.
Hermosura with a wind-up. Sing Song was there. Lipat. Blocked. And De Leon, good job.
De Leon, good timing on that.
That's her second block. Talking about to si Donna May De Leon. And now it's the time for Ana Hermosura. Hailing from Iloilo City. Serving now para dito sa Taytong.
Let's see, she did that service ace a while ago.
Magnaye sets up Altea. Another net touch violation against Bacolod Taytong.
De Leon being too aggressive in the middle, causing her that net violation.
Those are costly ones, especially at this juncture. Jacqueline Lipat. Cortez, Montoro, picked up there. And Jen, Stephanie Arasan rather, has been the difference in this set, Holly.
You see that swag after that spike? Confident eh.
Naman na ba niya yan sa mommy niya?
Meron.
Meron, no?
Nabahiran konti.
22-19. Montoro tapping it over. Ato, chance ball. Cortez, she goes back to Alex. Good pick up by Sinson. Arasa na naman. Dikit sa net. And it's out. Humingi ng check ball. Non-given.
I think the referee, the first referee has the best sight there. No? Kasi nangyari sa harap niya yon. So, he called an outside on that.
And the younger Ramos will check out. Balik muna ulit to si Chuatico, who's now at the front line. Donna May De Leon serving.
So it's Altea and Chuatico going head-to-head in the middle and the front.
Altea na nag-set. Arasan. Di na-cover ng maayos ni Montoro though. So a chance ball for the girls in black. Good block by Chuatico.
Good cover by UST.
Montoro once again. Medyo hindi na solid yung mga palo ni Montoro. Arasan, napayungan ni Chuatico. Cortez goes back to Montoro that time. A little oof on that spike galing dito kay Alex Montoro.
You see the decision making by Cortez gambling on that. And it, fruitful naman yung gamble niya na yun.
Six of her 8 points coming in this second set. Para dito kay Alex Montoro. Ramos also doing a good job. 9 points. Ooh! That is inside, clipping the line. Jen Stephanie Arasan.
She never gave up on that ball. You just see the confidence in her.
Sinundan niya talaga eh. And Marga Altea. Chance to give UST another point to inch closer to grabbing this set. But Chuatico tapping it in.
That is already a free point.
So ito na naman tayo. 1 point lead. Casey Cortez.
And she's been serving pretty good.
Oo. Quietly contributing to si Casey so far eh. Magnaye. Goes back to Arasan. Good floor defense that time around. Montoro. And ball awarded to Bacolod Taytong because tumama sa antena after that hit ni Montoro.
Magnaye was there but hindi lang well-established. She tried blocking that down-the-line hit.
Good eye by the referees. Pagka-check, tumama sa antena. Tabla tayo, Holly. 23-all. Look at that.
Kayo na, 22-all ng first set. Let's see.
Magnaye, dikit sa net. Kaya naman, naitapik ni Chuatico. A crucial error at that. Timeout, Coach Lur Magiron. Let's listen in.
Mo. Pasok mo. Yun dapat na malapit yung ano. Yun dapat ang ginanon mo. Hindi mo inintay bumaba. Kinahinawakan mo yung ano. Yung bola palabas na ganun. Ha? Ilaban mo!
Iba tapos, isa pa.
Tara, ilaban natin!
Umasa muna tayo ng maayos! Wala tayong pasay! Kalma lang, huminga kayo. Pagdating sa loob, pumposin yung sarili nyo. Pasa tayo ng maayos.
Let's go! USA!
Volleyball fans, this is your last chance today to win 500 pesos worth of Shakey's gift certificates in Plus Network's Guess Who contest. All you have to do is guess the name of the volleyball player through the pictures and clues that we have given. If you know the answer, drop your comments on the uploaded photo on the Plus Network Facebook page now to get that prize. And now, match point na ang Bacolod Taytong after trailing for the majority of the set, Holly.
Yes, talagang pinaghirapan nila to, no? I think Cortez was giving the balls to the spiker.
Let's see if they could seal the deal. Montoro, she finishes things off with another point. And what a way for Bacolod Taytong to advance. They were down by 6 points in this set, but managed to claw their way back into the game and got this set, winning it 25-23. Hindi naging madali, Holly.
Yes, pinaghirapan nila ma-igate to. This win, they were composed. I think that was one of the factors that they were trailing, but they just kept on pounding and pounding against UST. The composure was there also. You see also the maturity of them, no? Na ganun ka-level, yung ganun kalayong lamang nila, pero naihabol pa din nila. Ending sila pa yung nanalo ng match.
Nasubukan sila dito ng UST. UST really made them work for this win. But alas, etong Bacolod Taytong advancing to the semifinals via this hard-earned 25-22, 25-23 straight sets win over UST. Our MVP of the match in just a bit when we return, only here on the 2023 Shakey's Girls Volleyball Invitational League. Here as Bacolod Taytong advancing to the semifinals, but pinahirapan sila nitong UST. They win it in straight sets 25-22, 25-23, as we have here our MVP of the match brought to you by Shakey Super Delivery. Order favorite thin crust pizza and chicken and mojos now. Interesting choice rather galing sa'yo, Holly.
Yes, I find the setter of Bacolod Taytong, Miss Cortez, she gave composure. She led the team kahit down sila by 6. I think the composure and the distribution of the ball really made the difference niyo. Sinundan siya ng mga teammates niya on that kumbaga that mini run of theirs, and even her service was even also a kumbaga contributing factor on that win on those crucial win, actually, on that time na humahabol sila.
And here she is, Casey Cortez, our MVP of the match. Congrats, Casey.
Thank you.
So Casey, sabi nga ni Miss Holly, 6 points down kayo, 17-11 in set number 2. So, kwentuhan mo kami, paano kayo nakabalik and ano yung mindset coming into that juncture?
Nag-communication lang po kami sa loob ng court, tapos teamwork lang po, at makinig lang sa coaches po namin.
Yes, oh, nanonig ko din dun sa isang timeout ni coach na lamang kayo na isang set. Hindi ko lang kung tama yung pagkaintindi ko, pero lamang kayo na isang set. So, dapat mas paghirapan nyo pa tong set na to, di ba, para mapanalo nyo. So, ano yung naiisip mo nung time na yun? No? Ano yung parang, ano yung atake nyo by the next, kumbaga, sequence of points?
Dapat mag-double effort lang po kami sa loob ng court at huwag bitawan yung first set na panalo namin.
Ito, Casey, pagkakataon mo ng bumate at magpasalamat, go!
Hello sa family ko sa Bacolod, tapos hello kay, shout out kay Sir Boy, sa teammates ko, sa coaches, Coach B-Boy, Amber, Gwen, Sophie, hello.
Ayan, Casey Cortez. Alam mo, gusto ko dito kay Casey Holly, off it, on and off the court, relax lang.
Oo, no, parang kalmado, chill lang ako.
And she will receive a super card and gift certificates from Shaky. So again, congratulations Casey, papizza ka naman daw, sabi ng teammates mo.
Oo, share ka na ngayon yung pizza niya sa mga teammates niya.
And actually ito, Bacolod Titong will go home tonight at 8:40 p.m. dahil may ocular inspection daw sa kanila as we take a look at the set 1 highlights here. Actually, USD, maganda rin yung start nila. Set number 1, they led 15-12. Ginapang din itong Bacolod Titong, scoring 6 straight points and ultimately grabbing this set from them.
Yes, the game change was 22-all, pareho, no? But those crucial errors for UST on that first set, those two consecutive errors, ang nagbigay nung set na yon sa Taitung. But nevertheless, they gave it all on that first set, no? I guess that aggressiveness from Taitung was just medyo dominant on that one, on the first set.
And that's why they win that set 25-22. Pagdating ng set number 2, mas malalim na hukay yung hinabol nitong Bacolod Titong. Stephanie Arasan for UST was just really on a roll para dito sa UST. They led 17-11. Pero ang ganda ng habol ng Bacolod Titong, 5 straight points. And actually, lamang pa nga UST at the latter stages ng set number 2. But Bacolod Titong recovering just in time to grab this set and the win to advance to the next round.
Yes, the composure, I guess, really helped the Bacolod Titong team. Also, you know, Casey giving those fast sets na dun, hinabol lang talaga ng mga spikes. And at the first, they were having shaky receives, no? So, hindi makapasa ng maigi si Casey, but eventually, na-overcome nila yon.
And eventually, they win it in straight sets via hard-earned fashion, 25-22, 25-23. Let's take a look at the stats of this wonderful back-and-forth action between UST at itong Bacolod Titong, Holly.
You see, ano, lamang si Bacolod Titong on the score on the 50 of the 45, but the attacks, a little bit blocks, it's just the same. Tingnan mo, mas lamang pa si UST on the aces, which maybe the contribution na medyo talagang dikit yung ating match. But the opponent's error, UST giving more errors to Titong. So that's why medyo lumayo na lumayo yung score on the dikitang part na nung match.
And Bacolod Titong advancing to the semifinals. Makakasama nila dyan ang NU Nazareth School. Of course, for Bacolod Titong, they will face the winner of the match later on between Naga College Foundation and De La Salle pa. But first, up next na po ito, California Academy will take on the UAP Season 85 runners-up, Adamson University. That should be a good one. 2 more games here sa San Andres Sports Complex, Manila. On behalf of Holly Reyes, ako po si Ken Pangalinan. Maraming salamat! Stay tuned only here on the 2023 Shakey's Girls Volleyball Invitational League.